Reading was built in 1952. It was a state-of-the-art facility at that time. It has had a few additions over the years. It's almost 70 years old at this point, 69 years to be exact. Education has changed a lot since 1952 in those 69 years. Heck, it's changed in the last 30 years significantly. One, there wasn't thought when this building was initially built that someday that we wouldn't be using chalkboards or that we'd be using devices or smart boards and things like that. So there isn't a lot of electrical outlets or the capacity to put additional electrical outlets in this building. So you'll see as you go around the building, you'll see outlets that have 12 things plugged into them because we need that for today's education. We also are seeing that we have 1952 plumbing, we have 1952 heating and air conditioning. We have upgraded the air conditioning in this building. You'll see the original boiler that we had in 1952 that's still used to heat this building. It's long outlived its life expectancy. You could see within the building where the plumbing has become so fragile within the walls that we actually have plumbing outside the walls to go to water fountains and things like that that are necessities. We're not even talking about water filling stations like we have in many of our other buildings. We're just talking a water fountain. You also see as you walk around the building just deterioration of different areas. The custodial staff and support staff has done a wonderful job of maintaining this building and making it look great, but it's just wear and tear. I will challenge any of us that none of us, even if you have a house that was built in 1952, that you still do not have the same heating in that house that you had in 1952. You do not have the same technology that was in that house in 1952. You've made several additions and renovations to that house. The intercom system in this building has been here for a significant amount of time. And matter of fact, you can't even buy the parts to the intercom system to address the issues that we have. So there's not an intercom system throughout the entire building that's usable. So that would be something that we desperately need to address. The roof has reached its life expectancy as well. You see leaks in different areas and our facilities does a great job of trying to patch and put band-aids on things. If you look at that, we can continue to band-aid things. We can use what we're considering the local side of this referendum on 100% local $14 million of improvements to this building, but it's just gonna be band-aid. We're not gonna be able to impact the educational environment that these kids have every day. We're not gonna be able to make it a 21st century learning environment. We're not gonna be able to make it a smaller communities within the community that all the rest of the kids in our middle school students in our district get to experience. So our proposal for Reading to make it a 21st century learning environment, in 2006, the community supported us and we were able to build a new auditorium on the side of Reading. We plan to keep that. Also, there's a proud tradition, as I mentioned here, when this building was built in 1952. We like to keep the original front entrance of that building. And then we would take down the rest of the building. So anytime you either renovate a building, put an addition on the building, or go to build a new building, it represents a partnership between us, the local district, and the state of Delaware. In our situation, 76% of any new construction or renovation is covered by the state, and then locally we cover the other 24%. In construction in Delaware, it's done on a 20-year bond. So the state takes out of 76% of the cost, which in this particular instance is about $43 million. They take out bonds and they cover that aspect of it. And then as a district, we have to cover the other 24%, which in this situation is $14 million.
This new building will not cost our district taxpayers anything in terms of a property tax increase. So it's a no tax increase, a referendum, but to my way of thinking, it's a no brainer referendum. If I tell you that you can get a new school for the cost of system upgrades and repairs, to me, that's a no brainer. And so there's really no good reason why anybody should not be supporting this referendum.
We've actually proposed for Reading to be renovated over the last 10 years. This was the fourth time that we proposed for this to happen. And so we've been able to see this coming and knew someday that we would get approved for this. Or I guess maybe we didn't know. We were hoping someday we'd get approved for this. And so we've been able to save as we've gotten to that. And also we're able to use our voluntary assessment. Voluntary assessment is for every house that's built in our community. We currently get about $6,800 for that for every new home in our building. So we've saved that as well to be able to use to towards this no tax referendum. So basically, when we bond the about $14 million that's going to be needed for the local side of this building, we're able to bond that through those funds that we've been able to save and accrue.
What excites me most is being able to provide students and staff with an up-to-date historic building that goes into the 21st century, that is parallel to our sister schools within the district. Our students and staff want to know that they are regarded in the same way as those in the community. And I just think that the possibilities will be endless and it will be a safer and healthy learning environment.
For many years now, Reading Middle School has served as a reminder of Lewis Reading's legacy and importance. And with the passage of this referendum, that legacy and that history can be remembered for future generations and an exciting future with a brand new state-of-the-art school.
If we are able to get a renovation here, it would be definitely well deserved and well needed. So if we have a fresh, new, clean environment, very bright environment, it'll make our students be brighter as well.
Word I think of immediately when I think what the passage of the referendum means, it means opportunities. It means opportunities for kids. It means opportunities for the community surrounding Reading. It means opportunities for everyone in our district as far as that goes, because our school buildings just aren't a school building. They're a community resource and used by our community.